Hello, fire signs. Welcome back to my channel, Presence of a Goddess. How are you guys doing today? I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. Today's video is going to be based off the pink moon and what you can expect in your life after the pink moon. If it resonates, I appreciate if you like, comment, and subscribe. Support your girl. If it doesn't resonate, I do apologize. You can check your sun, moon, and rising. And if you want a more accurate reading with me, I have the Etsy shop link down below. Sorry, y'all. I got tongue-tied. So let's get started. I'll be using my Moonology deck in dedication of the pink moon. The super full moon. All right, spirit, what message do you have for my fellow fire signs? A new romantic cycle. Ooh. You could have Libra in your chart. It's time to release negativity. Full moon in Scorpio. You could have Scorpio in your chart. Have water in your chart. You might want to check out your water. Check out my water video to see if it resonates. I'm going to be using my Light Seer's deck. Spirit, what message do you have for my fellow fire signs? Oh, a bunch of cards want to fall out. We have the Temperance. You could be a Sagittarius specifically. All right, let me make sure. Spirit, can you knock one out for me? All right. And we have the Queen of Pentacles. You could be about your money. Somebody could be just getting a new job, getting their credit fixed. I'm getting a lot of credit fix. The Fool card. Somebody's taking a leap of faith on a business venture or some type of project. We have the Knight of Cups. Somebody is leaving someone behind. That could be a water sign. We do have the Ace of Wands. Someone is using their intuition, and their intuition is telling them that somebody is lying. We do have the Justice card. Yeah, definitely energy of getting clarification of who someone is truly, who they really are. The Chariot was upside down. Yeah, you're not moving forward with this person. You were planning a whole life with this person. You thought this person was the one, 11-11. But with the Four of Wands, it's like, no. No, this person could have been using you. This person could have been making broken promises. Could have been lying about a picnic that he was going to take you on. And never took you. You guys probably promised to ride horses. Never rode them. You know, festivals never took you. Carriage ride never took you. You know, Five of Wands. You guys having conflict. A new romantic cycle begins. So, yeah, you're leaving a water sign and you're going towards someone else. You could be leaving a earth sign, another fire sign, or you could be going towards a water sign. Take it as it resonates. Why is my cards all in? Y'all know I don't do. Okay. Yeah, you're giving up on this relationship. This was upside down, clearly. Spirits was like, nope, leave it like that. Yeah, so clearly you gave up on the relationship with the past person. You're going on a new romantic cycle. It's because you're releasing the negativity. The person that you, your past person, was drama. Five of Wands, drama. Always want to fight about nothing. And it was like you were talking to them till your face turned blue. You were tired of it. Yeah, Queen of Swords, you was like, no. You're getting cut off. That's, you see how she's thinking? You thought long and hard about this. I feel like you had weighed your pros and your cons. And you said no. Yeah, weighed your pros and your cons. The Justice card. Pros, cons. You said no. No. Mm-mm. You were manifesting new love. I feel like tonight, tonight you're manifesting new love. And Spirits is saying a new romantic cycle begins right after the pink moon. You see how that's balanced? You're going towards what balanced thing you weigh your pros and your cons. And it's like, I'm going to leave. I want someone I can balance out with. you're manifesting a new beginning with someone else. It could be somebody you already know and you wanting them back, realizing that they are the one. Oh, that sounds like the water sign. That sounds like one of the other signs. It could be another fire sign, but with the King of Wands energy, this could be your energy. You're like, I'm standing my ground. I know what I want. And it's not only in love, but also in, you could be specifically a Leo, that you're also standing your ground on what you want in your life. It's like, I know what kind of person I want in my life. I know what kind of career, business I want. Like I told you, some of you guys are taking a leap of faith on a new business venture. And so, yeah, with the Eight of Pentacles on the top deck, it's like you're focused on your coins. You're focused on your business, on expanding yourself. Five of Swords, that person gave you headaches. That person was stressing you out. It's like, you see that bird on his shoulder? That's all it, just yap. Always wanting to argue with you. Fire signs. And it was like, no, get out of my face. Because it's like, yes, you're a very feisty person. But also, you're very loving as well. And it's like, when you're in love with someone, you don't want to keep arguing with them. And it was like, not even the good passionate argument, like, oh, we're having sex after this. It was like, you want to go sleep on the couch, sir. But it's like, you were going within yourself, healing yourself with the Star card. It's like, I feel like you know what you want in life. This is your desires. This is you manifesting the night in the pink moon. Like, I want new love. I want a new job. I want to make new income, a new business. Not even a new business, but I want to expand my business, better my business. I want more customers, stuff like that. And I feel like it's happening. Spirits is like, it's happening. You see how that's glowing? That's your dreams glowing. And you knew this. You're good at manifesting fire signs. It's like in your DNA. Look, this is her. I feel like you give a lot and you get a little. That's what I'm getting. Let me see what's on the bottom deck. Yeah, Knight of Wands. You finally letting go of being with that person that was in and out of your life, which was your past person. And I feel like you ready to be with someone who can balance things out with you. You don't want negativity because that's not what you're about. You're a loving person. You could have heavy water in your chart. And that's why so much emotions is in you. That's why you're so loving and you're not so much of a fire sign, as feisty, because that's not in your heart. You know, that's not even in your chart. With the High Priestess, it's like, yeah, you're rising to your higher self. And your person wasn't. Your ex was not. Your ex was still low vibing. I'm surprised the karmic card didn't come out. The devil card didn't come out. It's like, I feel like some of you guys met your soul tribe. Three of Cups. It's like, you know who your friends are and who aren't your friends and who aren't supposed to be in your life. It's like, you have a group of friends and you all have similar goals and you share similar stories. Even if it's just one person, it's like, you feel like you get support. You know who supports you and who don't support you. You feel like your ex was a hater. I feel like some of you guys feel like they didn't commend you on your dreams. They didn't stand by you on your dreams. But it's like, Nine of Cups, you want to feel free. And you do, the fire part in you, you're quick to let go. What makes you caged in, you know? Not a sword. You let him go quick. You like, you know, you're not having that. Because you know what you want. You're the Empress. The world is not only in your hand, but in your belly. You create life. That's why you're like, who are you to tell me what I'm capable of? It's like, I can manifest new love. You know? Yeah. You could have been messing with an air sign, the King of Swords. Or just somebody in that energy of just always wanting to give you a cold shoulder and argue with you. Like I said, they had abandonment issues, Five of Pentacles. So it's like they try to argue with you to keep you in a way, you know? Like, and then try to guilt trip you like, oh, you're going to leave me like the rest of them. Like, what? Anyway, it's like, then it's like, now you're realizing, like, I got my future to focus on. I don't have time to be taking care of another child, you know? Some of you guys don't even have children. You're like, I'm not, you're childish. All right, so I'm going to use the Real Talk deck and see what we have for you, fire signs. 944, look that up. That's mean stability. expansion. All right, first. Okay, so you got the same thing as the water sign. Like I said, you could have heavy water in your chart. Remember that self-care sometimes involves putting yourself first. Set healthy boundaries and take care of you. Metaphorically speaking, place your own oxygen mask on first before assisting others. All right, Spirit. I'm going to do one more for y'all. Gratitude. Some of you guys are probably good at meditating. Like I said, manifesting. All that. You're into that because you're protected. So gratitude, expressing gratitude for where you are and what you currently have, raises your vibration and shifts your focus from lack. Incorporating this into your practice can fast track manifestations and keep you in the present moment. So make sure you're setting healthy boundaries, even with your new love. Make sure you tell them what it is and what it isn't. And you be appreciative of how far you came. Do not feel like you lost something because you didn't. You need to look back on how far you came, how far you grew. You know what I'm saying? You were low vibing at one point. Probably was drinking a lot. Probably was partying a lot. Now you're just chilling and got goals coming in. That's, and you manifesting real goals. Even if it's small, they're coming true. You need to believe in yourself, how gifted you are. You know? You are the high priestess. And you are going to expand that business. It's going to come true. The full is new beginnings. You're embracing change in all aspects in your life. In love, you're leaving the negativity behind. A new romantic cycle begins. Someone who's going to love you. It could be a water sign. You guys could be mirroring each other. That is, you know, stability. That's what's coming in your life. That's why you are the Queen of Pentacles. Your business is going to be booming. You're going to be getting overtime. You're going to get a raise. You're going to get your credit. You're going to get a new home. You're getting a new car. Whatever you apply for, it's going to contain stability. Whatever you invest in stability. Spirits is saying stay humble. Gratitude. Stay humble. Do not lose focus. Yeah, you're mirroring that water sign. They have water in their chart. Next caller. Yeah, you're moving forward. New romantic cycle begins. 1227, look that up. I'm doing one more ghetto oracle card. Your star. Yeah, some of you guys could have a platform and you're going to be getting more viewers. Girl talk. Surround yourself with support. Like I told you, your soul tribe. The Three of Cups. It's like your soul tribe. You're going to support. You're accepting support. And that's all that matters. I don't can't find it, y'all. There we go. Yeah, girl talk. You have a whole tribe that listen to you. This is who gives you strength. Your gratitude, you're grateful because these people around you are giving you vibes. They're giving you vibes. Your energy speaks louder than words. So it's important to be cognizant of not only your vibes, but those of your surroundings. If at any point the vibes feel off, grab a crystal. Center yourself and or exit stage left. Vibes. It's time to release negativities. Vibes. What I just said. Protect your energy. Sage. Keep yourself grounded. Keep manifesting. Keep letting spirit know what you're grateful of and what you want of. Speak what you want. Claim it. Okay, a new romantic cycle begins. Watch the water sign if you're a cross watcher. The divine feminine wanted to come out as well. Divine timing, I'm sorry. This is your divine masculine or divine feminine that's coming in your life. And they're going to show you true love. And you feel this coming because you're very intuitive. Spirit already told you. All right, fairy signs, that's all I have for you. And if you want to book a personal reading with me, the link is down below. Simple steps. Okay, guys, I appreciate you. If this resonates, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Till later, guys.